typical Japanese koi farm in the heart of Niigata, the Kaneko koi farm, with all these shirochuri, and I think that is the reason why we still visit Kaneko today. The shirochuri are top quality, really good. The Kaneko koi farm has over 50 mud ponds outdoor for growing its koi. Most of these are used for growing up young koi, but also a few are used for larger koi. But let's see what else we can find on this farm. This koi house is more in the back, everything isolated as well. And these are goldfish actually. I think the variety is Tamasava. The wooden beams in this building also look very nice, gives it a more traditional look. In this building are most of the Nissai of the farm. Kaneko doesn't breed a lot of the standard varieties. The focus is especially on Shirochuri and Kujaku, but also Goshiki, Koromo, Kikokuyu and other Deutsche varieties. But the standard koi like Sanka, Kohaku and Showa, you won't find a lot of them in this building. Just not his thing, I guess. You better go to another breeder for that. Spasito Kataoka. Playing around a little bit.
This one. Macho the fisherman. Macho the fisherman.
Trying it one more time. Show us what you got, Macho.
Ah, shit. Impossible.
And actually one more try.
Impossible.
A lot of different varieties. Kujaku, Koromo, one more. Crazy how many of these small koi fit in one of the ponds. Tens of thousands. That's so crazy swimming after each other. They just keep following each other. Like creating their own whirlpool. And on the Kujaku again, following each other in their own whirlpool. Kaneko himself, selecting Shirochuri. The Shiros are really light color still, but Sumi needs to develop later. Oh, that's effective. Look at that. They all just follow each other and swim in the net. In the standard, you put the net in. And this is more the serious stuff. This is one of the koi houses of Kaneko, where the more larger koi are swimming around during winter time. This is a Tansho Kujaku, only having a red marking on the head. And I don't even want to ask for a price, honestly, because this is seriously beautiful. This is very nice. Look at the skin. The scales. It's metallic looking, it shines. This will look very nice when the sun is shining on it. And another one. Her sister probably. maar Sito had daar ook een netting in. De koi bag, very effective way by the way. Okay, let's see. Also, even in fin, there's like a black marking, called it Motoguru.